Welcome to part 4 of my 3D screencasting series. In today's episode, you'll learn how to use rotoscoping and inverted masks to isolate your desktop in preparation for our 3D animations. Let's get started. And our next step is to come back to this duplicated screen footage, and we're just going to go ahead and solo that layer and do some more rotoscoping. Now, in this particular case, what I want out of this layer is I actually want to see the mouse movements that occur as the mouse moves onto the screen and then moves off of it at the end. So if we scrub back and forth here, we'll see at the beginning the mouse starts off in the lower right-hand corner over here, and as we move into the shot, it gets up into the control panel. And then towards the end of the shot, it'll actually come off of the control panel. So I want to get rid of the control panel and just sort of have this transparent desktop. We'll just look at that. I want this transparent desktop, but I want all the mouse movements that happen on the outside of that control panel. So to make this happen, we're going to go ahead and just rotoscope out this layer a little bit. So we'll grab our pen tool again, and real quick and dirty again for the demo. I'm going to cut out the control panel, and we'll just click around the edges, sort of close, until we've got that cut out. I'll switch back to my pointer tool here, and if I untoggle one of the soloing on this layer so I'm only seeing that screen footage there, you can see I've got this layer cut out, but I've actually hidden all of the areas I want. So to change that, I've got to invert this mask. So again, with this layer selected, what I want to do is I want to hit the M key, and that'll display my mask. It'll twizzle it down, and I want to come over to the inverted checkbox and just make sure it's checked. And you notice now that inverts, so I'm seeing these areas of change. And when I turn on my soloing for that desktop underneath it, you see I've now got this really nice piece of footage where the mouse is moving around. Looks real pretty. All right, so we'll unsolo both of those, and again, just for the sake of cleanliness, we'll go ahead and pre-compose these. So both layers selected, come up to the layers menu, pre-compose again, and we'll call this desktop. Okay, so I've now got these two layers, which are pretty much set up now so that I can create some really nice 3D effects.
Hey, thanks for watching. By now you should be starting to master the pen tool, and you should realize it's a super heavy-duty skill that opens up a lot of possibilities for you. But we're not finished, and you won't want to miss the next episode. We're going to learn how to animate that window in 3D space. So, I'll see you then.